Good morning, graduating AEC Owls, junior marshals, family, friends, faculty, and everyone in between. It is my honor and privilege to welcome you all once again, you've all been pretty welcomed at this point, to the second ever Alexander Early College graduation commencement ceremony. My name is Courtney Gann. I've had the pleasure of meeting most of you through the past 4 years, whether that was through classes, student-led conference nights, or information sessions. But for all of you that I haven't yet met, I want to extend an especially warm welcome. Thank you for coming to celebrate with us today, even in a strange time like this one, where we really don't know what's going to happen. Before I talk too much, I want to ask you all, class of 2021, to give yourselves a ginormous round of applause, because we deserve it, and we have worked so incredibly hard, and the day is finally here. So, wow, class of 2021, how weird does that sound? I remember when I first attended the summer camp for rising freshmen all the way back in 2017, and we were all given shirts that read class of 2021 on the front. And when I got my shirt, I looked it over, kind of inspected it a little, and I kind of muttered to myself, 2021. And I kind of felt, tried to see how it felt saying it. And the year felt foreign coming across my lips. 4 years. The years felt heavy, looking forward to the commitment to education that I was making, that we were all making, when starting at AEC was absolutely terrifying. Not only were we entering a new grade, but we were entering a new era, an era of high stakes and high expectations, but even higher rewards and higher achievements. An era of strife and growth and love and loss and everything in between that we couldn't even fathom at the time. But even then, even though we had no idea what was coming, we were still a little bit frightened. However, soon enough, the fear wore off. I, like most of you, remember even being intimidated by the legacy class of 2020. But this did not last long. From even our first days at AEC, memories were being made. Memories that we didn't even recognize as important then, but now we'll cherish them for a lifetime. Soon enough, walking into school in the mornings was a breath of fresh air. 9 times out of 10, students, teachers, and faculty were all welcoming faces, and at 8 a.m., no less, I still don't understand how they did it. Even Mr. Evans contributed to this atmosphere, but only after copious amounts of coffee, or 10 a.m., whichever came first, we learned that quickly. Not all mornings were perfect, though. There was the day when the fire alarm randomly went off before the day even started, and that gave us all a big jolt. It definitely woke us up bright and early. I can gladly report to you all today, though, that the fire alarms are sure to work at AEC, because they definitely did that morning. There are mornings where Pop-Tarts got burnt in the microwave, and that smell is still stuck in my head, because that's probably one of the worst things to ever happen. There was even the time that a gigantic spider of anaconda proportions, seriously, was on the loose in Mr. Bumgarner's room during study hall, and everyone was screaming bloody murder, clamoring over one another to get out. It's funny, we've been through lockdown drills, near monsoons, college placement tests, the ACT, and my personal fear, 8 a.m. history lectures, but I have never seen the school on higher alert than I did that day. No matter what, though, we all got to class by 9:52 in one piece, and I consider that a huge win. And the classes, it's crazy to believe we once had schedules with only 3 high school classes a day. Soon enough, we were navigating the worlds of both college and high school life. But I, like many of you, would not have it any other way. We have had so many fun times in those classes. In English, we acted out Romeo and Juliet, and we showcased some pretty tacky acting skills. I know mine were a lot far from commendable. In world history, we had Life 101 lessons of the day, which were always a favorite of mine. And in science class, we played Kahoot and Jeopardy to review for tests, and it got way too competitive at times. I'm looking at a few of you specifically, y'all know who you are. In biology, we laughed when we couldn't say our class password, which, if I remember correctly, was superfluous phlebotomy. I hope you're proud of me. While we had a lot of fun and so many laughing fits, we also truly learned a lot. I mean, Mrs. Sharp's quadratic formula song still gets stuck in my head. X equals negative, you get the point. Mrs. Bumgarner's connections from books to real-world problems still sticks with me. And every time I read a book or an article or anything, I find myself trying to draw ties from the books to the real world and pick out metaphors like I'm preparing for class discussion the next day. While we left our mark on it as the second grade to ever grace the school's halls, in the same way, AEC, primarily its community, certainly left its mark on us. And then, like the conflict of a storyline, COVID-19 hit. Suddenly, our family of owls could only connect through a screen. Group projects were only available through email. And our patience with technology grew thinner and thinner by the day. I know mine definitely did. But in true AEC fashion, we persevered. We had once navigated a near new institution and paved our own ways. With that, we were able to adapt our new learning environment and use it to the best of our abilities. I'm pretty sure at this point that we could all add fluent in Zoom to our resumes, because I know I definitely could. However disconnected, we were never truly apart. Even in the face of adversity, our OWL family stayed strong. I mean, obviously so. We're all sitting here today, and I know you all are as amazed and proud as I am. Above all, friends, this past 4 years has been a time for tremendous growth. Not only that, but growing together. Not once did I feel in this school like there was a competition to be the prettiest, the most popular, the smartest, or the fittest. Instead, we truly were a family that celebrated each other's accomplishments as if they were our own. A leap for one of us was truly a leap for all of us, and we found that the greatest leaders could be found teaching our classes or sitting next to us in study hall. Don't get me wrong, we did have our fair share of drama, and anything that happened at lunch would certainly make its way around the student body and back by the beginning of third block because we're such a tiny school. But the thing about AEC that has always stood out to me is our ability to unite. With such a small school, especially in our earlier grade levels, tensions resolved quickly because we basically saw everyone in the school each day and even collaboratively worked with most of them, so we kind of had to get over our issues. We all have our own takeaways from Alexander Early College. We have learned that we can achieve nearly anything by just working hard and having a good attitude. We have learned that everyone has a story to tell, and it is valuable to listen to each and every single one of them. We have learned that adaptability is important to being truly successful. But above all, I think we learned the value of working together. Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is a progress. Working together is success. These are the wise words of Mr. Henry Ford, all the way back in the 19th century. How crazy is it, though, that we can still apply these words today? Peers, we are a shining example of this quote. After all, we came together in the beginning. We started out a bit divided, but we all assimilated together. This is where we kept together and filled the last 4 years up to the brim with progress. Overall, we have worked together tirelessly throughout our high school years to reach success. The very success that we are celebrating today. Class of 2021, it is important that we keep this momentum going. Whether you're going directly into the workforce or continuing your education, the power of togetherness never really goes away. We will always be a family of owls, but it is important that we spread our wings and keep making new connections and building new teams so that we can come together, keep together, and work together in new ways. Owls, I could go on, and I'm sure you all could too. We have hours upon hours of stories to tell, jokes to make, and lessons to recollect. Instead, though, I invite you all to dive headfirst into the future. The memories we have made will be here for a lifetime, but the future begins now. Take that sense of together that we have learned from one another, and go hunt for the success that we have all been prepared to chase, the success that we have already started achieving. With this teamwork attitude and the tools for greatness that we have been given, we can soar high with our wings and grasp life with our talons. Thank you.